talking with them. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. I heard he's mad at me cause I'm getting money. I heard he's mad at me cause he told me. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. Mad at me cause I'm shining. They ain't seen it when I'm young, out here grinding. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. Either way, young, getting paid, yeah. I heard he's mad at me cause I'm popping. They don't wanna put some money in my pockets. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay, yeah. Either way, a hater always gonna hate, yeah. Mad at me cause I'm trying to feed my. I'm supposed to make it out and I don't bring my. No way, no way, no way, yeah. They ones and they here to stay, yeah. I heard he's always hating, said I'll never make it.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, a very good defense will be on the field. The Panthers are top 10 in fewest points allowed. They'll be up against the Lions offense that wants to prove it can do some damage.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault. And that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the Carolina Panthers. A first carry for Amir Abdullah. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Again, it's Abdullah, and that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. From the gun on third down, Webb. And he connects with Ebron. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. So even with the pass interference, it's a completed pass. They'll go ahead and just take the play instead.
How about the effort? Making the catch despite the pass interference. Nothing else to be gained on the play. No need to take the penalty. The play stands.
Gone! Leopard! Set!
Following the penalty, Abdullah. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position, the guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front has eaten up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Shift together here from the D-line. On first and 10, Webb. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
A second down run for Abdullah. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. A 4-yard pickup that gets him going forward, but still 15 yards left on third down.
Three down.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Throwing on 3rd and long. Webb, and he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up 4th down. Now Jordan Berry on to kick this one away. They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Out of bounds and close. The question, was it a touchback? No. They'll say it crossed out at the 2-yard line. And tough starting field position here. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that run, that changes the whole mentality about the drive right there. They were starting on their own 2-yard line. They just wanted enough space to punt the football successfully. Now they're talking about putting together a drive.
And they'll get him down up past the 15. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. Second down following the run.
Here we go. Watch it now, Barney. Barney. Barney, look at this.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Let's go.
On first down, Abdullah. He fights forward for a couple with a penalty flag down. And the linemen, they're already walking back. So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
All right, here we go. Three,
out of the gun, it's Webb. That's complete to Taywan Taylor. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's a 14-yard pickup, but it'll still be second down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback has to slide and find open space to throw.
To throw on second down, here's Webb. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Play fake. Now Webb. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week. Three interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
Hurry up. Here we go. Blue liner. Back line up. Back line up. That's going to be a long... Let's go. Blue liner.
Now a play fake here on first down. Rush coming in. He's taken down. Jared Davis not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. Less than a minute to go here in a scoreless first quarter to this point.
Green 39. Green 39.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. A good pickup there. 13 yards as they get closer for third down. In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a 3rd and 7.
Let's go!
They'll drop the throw. Got his target, Samuel. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number 2. And they've got it here with a 1st down. So they're operating in the red zone.
Here we go now.
They'll look to throw here. Slide it, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Deion Buchanan in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. And this is scooped up by the Lions. He's got the lane, and there he goes. The 20. And into the end zone. A scoop and score on the fumble return for the Detroit touchdown. Fumbles, that's how you get in the coach's doghouse. The first one lost and it hurt. This time you lose it and it's taken in for a score. It really hurt.
And about that doghouse, it won't exactly be comfortable and it definitely won't be air conditioned.
Milk bones?
None.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This one taken from the 7. And he comes up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line.
Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. Start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he'll get about four across the 30 to the 32.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
Chains.
I like how they work the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Call it a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll bring up a third and 11 situation.
Here we go.
Looking to throw. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
As diverse as the running game has become in the NFL, there's still a place for the fullback position. And on that play, he gained nice yardage.
Meanwhile, on the NFL scoreboard, a game going on in Chicago. And early on, the driver's seat belongs to the Seahawks. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout. Out of the gun now on third down. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
Here we go. Green.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Throw left side. McCaffrey's got it. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it second and 14. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this.
right, here we go. Green, 39.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Cohen. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Throw again. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And his crew will take over with the football at the 35-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
And a great spot to start this drive from here.
No. Check. Patriot.
A handoff. McCaffrey running right. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. He'll look to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The Panthers on third down, a perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is going to be third and 13.
Here we go now. Over. No. Check. Patriot. Gone.
They'll set up to throw. He sets to fire deep. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Darius Slay with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. Shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Second down, Webb. He goes underneath to Abdullah. And they'll get him down here at the 23. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Here's Webb, and he fires one, but incomplete.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach, and incomplete. Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. Carolina getting set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. This one complete to Devin Funchess. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Not
because
at all.
Those are the types of plays that he provides. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Going up top. It's caught inside the 25. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. From the right hash, it's a 38-yard attempt. And the kick by Butker is good. They're in the second quarter at Heinz Field. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Lions offense, they get ready to head back out there. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And I would say they went 3 and out last time, but actually they didn't even get to 3 and out. Still a strange decision to us here in the booth.
Yeah, let's hope they don't go 1 and out, but maybe, possibly, let's try and think with them here. Try to play field position, maybe. Turn the ball over, put it in the hands of their defense. Who knows?
You're a nice man. So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we send you now to Orlando and our Tiburon studios, where Larry Ridley's standing by with our EA Sports halftime report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll set up a throw. He's going to go deep for Funchess. And that's caught inside the 30. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line. A big play there for Carolina. 68 yards.
Let's go. Green, Detroit! Detroit!
Back to throw. He's got it for a Panther touchdown.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. It's good to make it 17-7. Gano out to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So we get a look at the Lions offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you a
play. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
To throw on second down, here's Webb. Over the middle, that's caught by Taylor. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. From the gun on third down. Webb over the middle complete. That's Taylor. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Taylor. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
And down inside the 15 he goes. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Man, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. Well, earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice, safe throw and a good one.
Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. Here we go now. Looking to throw on second down. Webb. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
I think there he had to come off of his primary receiver in a big way, just trying to get it to a secondary guy. Unable to get that play completed.
Check down, but didn't even have enough time to do that. Incomplete. A play fake. Now Webb. Webb can't escape. As he goes down, Whitney Mercilus in there to get him, and that's sack number 12 for him on the year. And Zerline's kick is good, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. A decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged 3 out of it, but they do inch a bit closer.
Yeah, still lots of time to go in this one. Take the points, move on, and let your defense try to get the ball back.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They go play action here on first down. And caught left side, Olsen. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. A give running left. It's McCaffrey. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On second down, McCaffrey. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A big play there with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. From Soldier Field, meanwhile, in Chicago, a third quarter score. And the Seahawks fans have to be happy. That lead just got bigger. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. This will be fielded at the six. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. The completion good for three, and it's second down. To throw on second down. Webb. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
The Lions on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and seven. The gun, it's Webb. Over the middle, complete. It's Taylor. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. On first and 10, Webb caught on the right side by Jones. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage.
Set. Green, 39.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Darrell Worley. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line. So now he's equaled his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had 3 last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down. Told the guys on the team, don't worry, things are going to pick up. I've got this. But he is in a major league rut right now. Let's see if his teammates can pick him up along the way.
You're right. He talked about being cool, calm, collective, rebounding. Not rebounding right here. Now a play fake here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be second down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he's got room. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Throwing right, and that's complete. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And oh my goodness, he loses it again. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football. And the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game. So hold on here, not done in the fourth. And he's brought down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth. You know, because you always hear about the smaller running back. Like, it's lost, you can't find him. And sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost, but this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Now a first down throw. Webb, the left side completion to Jones. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. In the red zone this time.
Back to Josh Bailey. Here we go. Over. Here we go. Green three.
Looking to throw on second down. Webb over the middle into traffic, and that's complete. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On the run, it's McNichols. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
The slot man in motion right. To throw on second down. Webb. And that is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Taywan Taylor. And it's third down. Well, too much oomph. Too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Third down, Webb. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And it's caught. They didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one. The decision to go for it pays off, and now they're set up first and goal. Webb now from the gun. And Ebron's got it.
Touchdown, Lions! Eric Ebron, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions able to get this back within a touchdown. He's got it, and it's 24-17. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Well, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. That good for 19 at a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Throw. It's caught by Funchess. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 18 yards there, down to the 18 and a first down. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it, and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and it'll be second and 12. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push them back more. This is McCaffrey on the give. 12 yards is the pickup there, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
And the play clock is going to run out here. They're in no hurry to get a playoff. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
The offense on third down tonight, they've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. They're looking at third and a few inches. McCaffrey following the penalty. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. A great play there with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And the lead is Raiders up to 14. Gano out to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So out now come the Lions. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Off play action, it's Webb. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Taylor. And some big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground. Down at the 32-yard line.
Here we go. Over, over. Here we go. Good, good. Good, good.
Off the play fake. Webb. That is caught inside the five. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal.
Let's go.
Operating from the gun, Webb. And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
The fourth quarter score now from Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. And the Steelers coming away victorious there. If they hang on, that would up their win total to 5 on the season so far. Are going to recover here, and that should be enough to get them the victory. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal, that's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for the Panthers, a final win here means they'll finish off the regular season at a solid 13-3. And now they'll await the final seeding for the playoffs ahead. Meanwhile, for Detroit, this might wind up being a tough pill to swallow as they're going to finish the season at 9-7. And it's going to be finger-crossing time as we await the final shakedown of this year's playoff picture. So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.